This interest rate report brought to you by Macquarie Bank.
The RBA this month decided to keep the official cash rate on hold at 1%. Macquarie has adjusted its thinking and now sees the likelihood of an interest rate cut in October rising, followed by another in November. Here in Australia, the mixed signals from economic data weighs more heavily to the downside. However, in our view, the RBA will wait for the second quarter GDP growth number, which is released after this month's board meeting, before acting. The GDP calculation includes the recently released construction activity, which was weaker than expected, down 3.8%. All key components, such as private new dwelling construction, non-residential construction, and private engineering, fell during the quarter. Inflation remains a problem for the RBA, a factor of tepid wages growth. And they now assume it will take longer than early expected for inflation to return to the bottom of the preferred range of 2 to 3%. Employment growth is holding up. However, the unemployment rate at 5.25% reflects the rising number of job seekers. For wages growth to start to improve, we need a tighter labour market. And Macquarie estimates unemployment will have to fall to 4.5% to do so. The recent rebound in house prices will be monitored. However, RBA Governor Philip Lowe is firm in his view that housing credit growth is unlikely to pick up sufficiently to be problematic for now. It'd be impossible to ignore the trade war and the downside risks to global growth from it. The likelihood of the major central banks adjusting down their interest rate settings in September will also be hard to ignore. It's widely expected the US Federal Reserve Board will in fact cut rates in September. As such, the RBA has downgraded its growth forecast to 2.5%, but have maintained a 2020 growth rate forecast of 2.75%.